All right, thank you for joining us, Ronke Giwa Onafuwa.
Thank you for having me, Toyosi. Good to be on the hot seat this time around.
Yeah, it's my pleasure. A lot of teenagers listening right now would like to know, what are the things that you experienced as a child while growing up that shaped you into the superstar you are now?
Oh, thank you very much. Well, let me see. My childhood was a lot of fun. I grew up amongst, you know, siblings and lots of cousins. I had four siblings. Mm. And so we all grew up really close knit. We're like the average sort of middle class family. It wasn't like we're wealthy, but we're not poor. And, you know, our parents sort of were very, you know, big on education. So he tried to put us in some of the best schools. But one of the fundamental thing for me that made us really close was, I mean, when I was growing up was when generators were not very popular. So when there was a power outage, for example, everybody would be out by the balcony playing monini, monini, monini. Yeah. And stuff like that, you know. So we had a lot of fun as siblings. We always had, in those days, the TV didn't start until about 4 p.m. or 5 p.m. Unlike now, where it's 24 hours. So those days, you have to find your fun. If there's no power, you have to come up with different games to do. And that really brought us together as well. And I feel that one of the things also that's made me the person that I am today is also mm-hmm. the discipline that I got from my parents.
Was it from your mom or your dad?
My mom was the disciplinarian. Oh Lord, my dad was very chill and very relaxed and very cool. But my mom, oh my days, she was a disciplinarian for two. So when my dad was very chill, she took the place of beating us, smacking us, you know, telling us off and making sure we had our heads screwed on tight. So our values, for example, I learned from my mom telling me things like, you know, you mustn't be too frequent at your neighbor's house, you know, or else you become unwanted, you become unwelcome, you overstay your welcome. I learned values like, you know, integrity and honesty. Those are things I learned from my mom, because my mom would sing songs like, you know, Motobak Buro Ajale. My mom would sing stuff like that and it has stuck to me till today, which is why for me, honesty, integrity, excellence is a big watchword.
All right, thank you. The question I would like to ask is a topic we are discussing today on the show, which is self-esteem and body image. So how are you able to build your own self-esteem?
Well, as a teenager, I mean, every teenager goes through that phase where you look at yourself and then you compare yourself to other people and you're wondering, oh, why are my boobs not as big as that person? Or why is my boobs too big, or my butt? Or, why do I have pimples? For me, I had acne when I was really young as a teenager. And then I used to feel like I had a big head. I don't know where it came from. Wow. People used to call me big head. People used to call me crab face. You know, I think the thing is, as teenagers, people are so mean to each other.
Yeah.
But you as a teenager have to rise above all those things and realize that nobody's perfect. Even those who are insulting you are not perfect. Now, that's what I learned. Even though it was later in life, I learned that, look, I am me. And there's nobody like me, and I may have my flaws, but that's what makes me me fundamentally. And nobody can be like me. Nobody can have my sets of flaws and strengths and all of that. And yes, there may be certain parts of myself that I may not like, but realize that if you take that bit out, the puzzle is sort of not complete. And it means that you're not really you anymore. So celebrate all those things, even if you don't really love them, because I mean, those days, people used to say, oh, flat-chested, shorty,
Smallie. So how did you
Smallie.
Go around them? Like, how didn't you allow those
things
words
get to me.
Put you down?
For me, yes, there were some times it would get to me. But I always, also because maybe from my family and the kind of home I came from was a home of love where, you know, so I was able to think there must be something wrong with you, not me.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm happy now because people used to call me Smallie, shorty. But now I don't look my age. I always say that.
Yes.
I'm still a Smallie, but I love that I'm petite and I celebrate that. So the things that you're unhappy about in future, you realize that, hey, that's actually what I love most about myself.
What kind of games did you play when you were a teenager?
We used to play 10-10, 10-10, 10-10,
Which was your favorite?
10-10? We used to play Suwe. Suwe is one where you throw a rock, you like sort of create these boxes, and then you throw a rock. I'm sure the people who are old school know. Throw a rock in there.
I don't even know about
what? Oh, Suwe was the best. And then you hop, and then whatever one you hop into, you pick up your stone.
Okay, a box.
Yes,
round.
You draw it on the ground and then you hop around in it and pick up the stone and throw it again. That was one of my favorites. My mom used to abuse me for it, but hey, I loved it.
What you're actually doing now, was it what you've always wanted to do?
No, not at all. I didn't even think that talking on radio or being a speaker was even a thing, because both those days, if you're not a lawyer or a doctor, you're just a nothing. But I was one of those confused teenagers who knew I didn't want to be a lawyer or doctor. but I really didn't know what I wanted to do. But it was right there. I was always the one speaking at events, even when I was little, emceeing my parents and their friends whenever they're around, conducting plays and conducting activities so that everybody would be entertained. It was right there, glaring. And I think parents need to be more watchful of what their children love to do. And then from there, you are not doing a job, but you're just enjoying what you do for the rest of your life.
All right. Before you go, what would you say to a 15-year-old you now listening?
Ooh, 15-year-old Ronke. Oh, let me see. 15-year-old, I was in SS2. So SS2 Ronke. Ah, Ronke, you know what? Don't do things to please other people. Yes, I know everybody has boyfriends and all, but you know what? That's just a waste of your time. Focus on your academics, listen in class, participate when teachers are talking. And then just live your life instead of wanting so much to be a grown-up, because now you're a grown-up and you're missing those times when you're 15. Look, grow-up days will come, but enjoy being 15 and enjoy being young and free.
Wow, thank you very much for coming.
Thank you very much for having me, Toyosi. I enjoy this very much.